The connection that we have with the cedar trees just cannot be measured. We call them elbow adzes. It's the branch of a tree, and the way to use them was passed on one generation to the next. But when we learned how to use the adze is when we moved out of the cave, because we were able to take the trees down and they became our clan houses, our totem poles, our dugout canoes. It's the backbone of our whole culture, even with the modern tools and equipment that we have nowadays. Very difficult to match what was done a long time ago. This is the number one tool that did it all. Well, I was 12 years old and I saw my dad carving and I knew that's what I wanted to do. That was the beginning of a long career. Art. Because carvers are different size, different weight, different height, then you make an adze that's made for you. Everybody's will be a little bit different, just like branches in the forest are all different. So are humans, and so are our tools. My world's pretty chaotic until I met my wife. Not necessarily going into the direction I feel that her and I are going today. It wouldn't happen without her. She's the anchor of my life. I am an artist, I think, and I've always spent my days being a wood carver. Now it's evolved into something a lot bigger. And what that means is that I have 48 years of working with wood, and I have a certain level of being in the right mind now. I want to be able to deliver some of that message to the young people and pass that train of thought on to them, because I think it's important. Most of the focus has been in the healing side of things and teaching. I do a lot of teaching young people. Now focus on specific target problems that all of us have. And maybe bring awareness and change of thought in somebody's life down the road. I live in 10,000 years of Tlingit history that is part of my life every day. Our culture is important enough not to lose.